Hey, it's Kai, and for today's video, we're going to be talking about the ways that Tourette syndrome can look different in people based on whether they're male or female. My last video was talking about my experience being misdiagnosed with functional tic-like symptoms instead of Tourette syndrome based on an atypical presentation that I had of tics. But after engaging a lot with the Tourette syndrome advocacy community, I realized that it's not really an atypical experience, it's just the experience of a lot of AFAB people with Tourette syndrome. So in this video, we're gonna talk about the ways that Tourette syndrome is different in female people. For the purpose of this video, I will be using the terms male and female to refer to physical sex, because that is what most of these research papers are based on. With all that said, let's just jump right into it. Female patients with Tourette syndrome are more likely to have tics that start at a later age compared to their male counterparts. We typically think of Tourette syndrome as starting around 5 to 7 years old. This is because all of the research on Tourette syndrome was performed on little boys, and so them being male did influence our understanding of Tourette syndrome. But female patients with Tourette syndrome are actually more likely to have tics that start in their teens or even into their adult years. This is the case with myself, and this is why we're much more likely to be told that we don't actually have Tourette syndrome, but we rather have something called functional tic-like movements. Additionally, female patients with Tourette syndrome tend to have tics that get worse as they get older, which is contrary to what we typically think of with Tourette syndrome, where tics are severe as a child and then you outgrow them in adulthood. Female patients with Tourette syndrome actually tend to have tics that are their worst in their teens or adulthoods and may not improve with age in the same way that male patients do. Along with a later age of onset, female Tourette patients are more likely to onset with complex tics rather than simple tics. When we think of the development of Tourette syndrome, we typically think of very small movements that start in the face and slowly move down the torso and out to the hands. In female patients with Tourette syndrome, rather than starting with minor motor movements like flicking a finger or scrunching up the nose, they're more likely to have their symptoms start as very complex movements, so things like saying full words or doing what may look like intentional movements like picking something up, throwing something, or hitting someone. They are less likely to, in their entire life, experience any simple tics. Female patients with Tourette syndrome are also more likely to have comorbid OCD rather than ADHD. They're also more likely to have mood disorders like anxiety and depression. And this may contribute to the reason that they have more complex tics, because we do know that when there's a strong overlap between Tourette syndrome and OCD, you're more likely to have more complex and compulsive tics. This greater presence of OCD, anxiety, and depression in female Tourette patients also contributes to them being misdiagnosed with functional tic-like movements. We typically think of Tourette syndrome having very high comorbidity rates with ADHD, but female Tourette patients are more predisposed to having OCD-type symptoms. Female patients with Tourette syndrome are also more likely to experience disabling tics in adulthood, which is likely due to their tics worsening with age rather than improving. As much as 1/4 of patients with Tourette syndrome report that their tic severity fluctuates with regards to their menstrual cycle, which may make their disorder profile look different than male patients. These are most of the sex differences that we already know exist in Tourette syndrome, but research on this topic is very much lacking, and so there may be additional differences that we're not yet aware of. But the idea that Tourette syndrome can look different based on sex is not a new idea and has been around since the 1990s. Nobody just really cares that much to look into it. With the sensational new idea of TikTok tics and functional tic-like movements, the sex differences that may be present in Tourette syndrome are a very relevant topic. The fact that 3 out of 4 patients diagnosed with functional tic-like movements are female, combined with the fact that all of the symptoms used to differentiate functional tic-like movements from organic tics are all just sex differences that we know exist in Tourette syndrome, should be enough to make anyone question the validity of the TikTok tics argument. And this is not the first time in history that these sex differences have been used to say that female patients don't actually have Tourette syndrome and they must have some other new disorder that just looks similar. The same thing happened in 2013 with the Leroy school incident. A group of teenage girls developed very sudden tic-like symptoms. Because of their late and sudden onset, they were told that they must not really have Tourette syndrome and it must be a socially contagious tic-like symptom, the exact same as what is being discussed in this TikTok tics narrative. Interestingly enough, social media was also called to attention during the Leroy incident, with social media posts on Facebook being blamed for these girls' sudden onset of tics. Before any weight is given to these arguments that these girls have socially contagious tic-like symptoms, I believe it is absolutely crucial that we look into what we already know about sex differences in Tourette syndrome and continue to dedicate research to that area before writing their symptoms off as some entirely new non-Tourettic disorder. Thanks for watching, and I hope you found this video informative. Make sure you subscribe and turn on your notifications so you know as soon as I post the next video. Okay, bye!